We all understand that no one knows what an actuary is, but on the rare occasion that I meet someone and I introduce myself as an actuary, it's happened on multiple occasions that they'll say, "Oh, so you know when I'm gonna die." Hi, my name is Michelle. This is Actuarielle, my actuarial YouTube channel. I actually don't work in life insurance, but I know that life insurance actuaries are what people think about when they think of actuaries. So today I'm gonna do something that I don't think I've done in an actuarial video since like 2014. I'm gonna talk about actuaries in the context of life insurance. I know, I'm the car insurance pricing queen! But actuaries and life insurance are like peas and carrots. They're best buddies. In my actuarial mathematics program, I had a bunch of courses on life insurance and exactly zero courses on car and home insurance pricing. A big chunk of actuarial science is life insurance math, and therefore I think it's important that you understand how this works. And I'm gonna bring in some help from the OG vlogger, Mr. Hank Green, guy I have been watching on YouTube for well over a decade. Because 3 years ago he posted this video and I saved it to a playlist and I said, this is an actuarial reference, this is gonna help me in a video one day. So let's let Hank explain what makes life insurance math exciting.
So the life expectancy of the average dude in the US is 76, but for me, it's 78. That's nice! I got an extra couple of years on the average dude. Look at me!
How did I do that?
Well, here's a statistic that might sound a little bit more surprising at first, but will help you figure out why. The average person will die at 76, but the average 76-year-old will die at 86. And the average 86-year-old, they will die at 91.
It's the idea of conditional expected values.
So I was hanging out with Thomas Frank earlier today of College Info Geek. He's 26 years old. His life expectancy is 77 years old. Mine is 78. What is up with that is that he has to live for like 11 more years before he gets to my age. Very sadly, some people will die, not very many, but some, between the ages of 26 and 37. I, on the other hand, because I am 37, will never have died between the ages of 26 and 37. I just can't do it.
I know. It's the idea of conditional expected values. What is the probability that I'm hungry at any given moment in a day? Probably high. What is the probability that I'm hungry given that I just ate lunch? Probably still high. I'm probably still gonna have a snack. Back in 2013 when I was taking my actuarial exams, I took exam MLC, Models for Life Contingencies. It has now switched into exam LTAM, Long-Term Actuarial Mathematics? Is that what it stands for? Life insurance math is a lot of conditional probabilities, a lot of conditional expected values. The idea of, given that someone is 29, like I am, what's the probability that they die in 1 year? What's the probability that they die in the next 50 years? When do we expect them to die? How long do we expect them to live? Actuaries look at something called a survival function, the probability that someone will survive over a period of time. A lot of the work is taking these survival functions and then calculating expected values, conditional expected values, probabilities, conditional probabilities from these functions. If you Google exam LTAM formula sheet, you'll find that one of the things the SOA gives you is the ultimate life table. If I could explain all the symbols on the top of this table, I would, but like I said, I passed this exam in 2013. It has been a hot minute since I have looked at them, and honestly, don't remember all of it. The leftmost column, the L sub X, is going to be the number of people that are still alive from a cohort of people. So in this case, you've got 100,000 people at age 20, and at age 45, you have 99,033.9 people expected to still be alive. From the information that actuaries derive from these cohorts of people and their survival or death rates, you can then slice out interim probabilities. So I remember doing a lot of math of, given that someone is 36, what's the probability that they live to age 45? Given that someone is 2, how long do you expect them to live? If any life actuaries have found this video, have watched this far into the video, like, thank you, but also roast me in the comments as I try to do the rest of this, or just this next specific part. Q sub X was the probability of mortality of a person of age X. Lowercase a was something to do with a life annuity. Uppercase a was something to do with, like, life insurance, so like a one-time payout as opposed to a multi-time payout, and then E, I have absolutely no idea what the what the E symbol meant. I don't remember. It's been a lot of years. But life actuaries, if you find this, let me know what E stands for because I don't remember. These actuary life tables that show cohorts of people and how many of them live or die also vary by different factors. You might have a different table for people who are smokers versus non-smokers because the way that we expect people to die is going to be different for people who are smokers. Friendly reminder that probably shouldn't smoke because it's bad and stuff. I'm much better at talking about car insurance, I assure you, so I kind of recommend that you watch one of those videos. Thank you for watching this far. Thumbs up the video, subscribe. Thank you for calling. Bye.